Well, good day, Derby fans, wherever you may be. I am Mike Checks alongside Tara Armoff, and you are watching the 2015 International WFTDA Championships live from the legendary Roy Wilkins Auditorium in St. Paul, Minnesota, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Minnesota Roller Girls.
And I hope you guys are as excited about this game as I am, because we are about to see the Kansas City Roller Warriors taking on the Sacred City Sacrificers. And we have Kansas City, Missouri, and Sacramento, California. And we have the number one seed. Kansas City was the number one winner from Cleveland. Mm-hmm. And Sacred City placed second in the Detroit playoffs.
That's right. Kansas City, the number 34 seed in the WFTDA, and Sacramento, Sacred City, number 47. Right now, we're going to kick it down to the floor to talk about the matchups. We're going to join Double H and Magilla Gorilla.
Hey, thanks, guys. I'm Double H here with Magilla Gorilla. This is going to be a fun game.
It really is. Division II never disappoints, Double H.
No, it never does.
What's interesting is watching these teams, how they've adapted after that time off. And obviously, Nashville played really well.
Time off?
Yeah.
What is time off?
They had a couple months since the last time they played. And which of these teams has done well in that time off? We've got a real contrast here, too, between these two teams. We talk about the blocking. They're a little bit different. They're not very similar in any way, actually.
No, and one of the things that I loved about Sacred City's performance in Detroit were their walls. Their defensive walls were amazing, and 6 points separated them and Nashville for the championship to come in here, the number one seed from Detroit. So they're doing something right, and I'm prepared to see them do that thing right all over this track right now.
For Kansas City, they're going to go with the game du jour, which is the braced wall, the shape of your choice, however you want to call it. They're going to play that route. For Sacred, it's going to be that straight wall. It's kind of a classic old school. Sacred's also going to go with a deep bunch of blockers. They're going to go with everybody. For Kansas City, they really focus on a couple blockers. You're going to see a lot of Enigma and a lot of Bruiser. They actually did 90-plus jams out of 137 in the D2 level. They play a lot of Derby.
And the thing that's exciting about Kansas City, of course, former top-tier, I would call it legacy league.
Definitely.
Former champion of the 2007 WFTDA Texas Shootout. So they are no stranger to tournament-level gameplay, and the hits they bring are hard, Gil.
Well, we talked about it beforehand. You know, it's a team that doesn't mind a little old school.
Uh-huh.
They don't mind, they get a little aggressive, and they're going to do that. They're going to use a traditional, the current wall, but they're going to hit off of it, and they're going to get aggressive, and they're going to lay some shots on the jammers for
the opposition. And they definitely use that to their advantage. They use that to their advantage in Cleveland against teams that maybe didn't train that way and maybe weren't as old. 2006 is when Sacred City started, so they might not get over on Sacred City with some of those hits.
Sacred City is going to go with three jammers.
Yep.
So they're going to have to be careful of those hits and keep themselves in play. For Kansas City, they're going to go deep. Mm-hmm. They're not worried about it. They got a lot of jammers, a lot of different things. They're even bringing up a junior Derby skater who graduated.
Jessica Boone.
That's right. So it's going to be an interesting contrast between how Sacred City can combat Kansas City's aggression.
Well, it's not going to disappoint.
No, it will not.
Whatever it is. So we won't waste any time.
No.
We'll get back to our friends Mike Checks and Tara for the game rosters.
All right. Well, we will start, Tara, with the Sacred City Derby Girls, as they are the number two seed in this bout.
They are the number two seed. They are the skaters in the white uniforms with a little bit of black trim. We have 0618 Pink Freud, 1 Kneel and Weep, 113 Annie Anklebiter, 12 Calamity Pain, 17 Rhodes Warrior, 27 Laura Stabs, team captain number 3 Sassy Longlegs, 44 The Forecloser, 451 Shock and Auburn, 58, Lushy, 606, Ariella Twister, 67, Rose Villain, 94, Talls, and 970, Narnar Jinx.
Well, and their opponents this morning, the number one seed Kansas City Roller Warriors All-Stars. They are in their black uniforms with dark red trim. Skating for them this morning, number 10, Enigma. Number 11, Rump Wrecker. Number 111, Annie Mall. Number 118 is Raina Payne. Number 23, Track Rat. 24, Team Captain, Bruiser. Number 3, Case Closed. 34, Accelerator. Number 4, Jessica Boom. Number 41, Mayhem Myers. 79 is Mary Lou Wretched. 84, Tough Noogies. 91, Foxy Brown. And AK-47, Lady Killshot.
And again, D2, So many fun games happen here, and I am really curious to see how this game goes, as we heard from Double H and Magilla Gorilla a few minutes ago, just the different styles that we're talking about. And both teams usually play on sport court.
Exactly.
We have concrete here at the legendary Roy Wilkins Auditorium. But I got a chance to talk to Forecloser from Sacred before the game, and she has opinions about different kinds of concrete. She says there's a little bit of bounce to this concrete, so it's not like the hard concrete where when you hit that you lose the will to live.
That's fair. The one thing that I noticed getting into the venue early yesterday, I actually walked the track, and there is a little bit of unevenness to it. We didn't really see that come into play in the first bout, so it may have just been walking over it. It felt more uneven than it feels to the skaters, but it was something that I noticed coming in early.
And also one of the issues that Sacred has sometimes, they sometimes have a lot of penalties on their board. And in Detroit, weather played a part in that it was very humid there, and that made the track more slick. And so they said that they got a little more penalties as a result of the unfamiliarity with the humidity. And nice and dry here by comparison. Nice, brisk Minnesota weather. So
hopefully that will make it easier for our referee crew this morning. Our head referee is Sir Osis. Inside pack referee, Matthew Manch. Jam referees, Harry Spotter and Professor Murder. Your outside pack referees are John Dilks, Mike Hammer, and Lauren Order. And your referee alternate, Tootie Tinwhistle. Well, we are seconds away from getting this bout underway, our second of the morning. Lined up on the jam line for Kansas City, that is Mary Lou Wretched, opposite Ariel LaTwister for Sacred City.
Sacred City already setting up a straight across wall right on that Fast Girl Skate start line. Kansas City setting up right in front of them, also in a straight wall.
And we are underway in this first jam. Ariel LaTwister starts to go to the outside. Now moves back to the end, finds the inside rail and clears. Lead jammer goes to Sacred City.
It was nice of her wall to just leave that little bit of an opening, maybe about 6 inches, so that she's able to get through. She's already on a scoring pass.
Mary Lou Wretched being contained by Sacred City's defense at the back of the pack. Ariel LaTwister already around the pack, through on a scoring pass. That should be 5 points. First blood drawn by Sacred City.
And we already have a Kansas City skater in the Derby Supply penalty box.
Ariel LaTwister threw on another 5-point scoring pass for Kansas City. Mary Lou Wretched had stashed the star. It has been passed to the pivot, who is now clear of the pack on her initial pass. That is Enigma for Kansas City as Ariel LaTwister threw for another 5. Enigma now coming up on the Sacred City defense at the front of the pack. This is her first scoring pass.
Ariel LaTwister not bothering to call it off. She trusted her teammate. She got through on the outside, picking up more points for Sacred City.
Well, and Tara, we are seeing more of that. Jammers trusting the blocking contingent that they have out there, choosing to stay out on the track and score points. Enigma now through the pack for 4 points for Kansas City. And Ariel LaTwister picks up 4 more. Sacred City, nice opening jam at 23. Kansas City, 4.
I do believe that is when the saying, shots have been fired across the bow, would apply so far. Want to say thanks to Jackson Skates for supporting WFTDA. More bang for your buck. See the Adam Booth. Oh, see the Adam Booth here in venue for details.
We've got Pink Floyd jamming for Sacred City, and that is Jessica Boom on her first jam for Kansas City, and a track cut call against Jessica Boom will send her to the penalty box. Pink Floyd and Sacred City in a power jam.
Pink Floyd fighting that 3 wall of black there in turn 1, getting knocked to the outside, getting drawn all the way back.
She will restart between the jam line and the pivot line, working on that initial pass, getting a little bit of offense from number 94, Talls, right there.
Talls not able to break up that wall. Foxy Brown and friends making sure that Pink Floyd is getting the most difficulty getting through.
Accelerator and Rump Wrecker, the last blockers. Pink Freud by now working on a scoring pass for Sacred City as Jessica Boom out of the penalty box for Kansas City.
That's right. Sacred going all defense in the back as Jessica Boom comes out of the box.
And now we have a track cut penalty leveled against Pink Freud. She is headed to the penalty box and Jessica Boom threw the pack clear on her initial pass.
Now we have a full 2-minute jam as a result.
Passive offense being set up by Kansas City between turns 1 and 2, now going active, trying to free Jessica Boom. This is her first scoring pass for Kansas City.
So much offense going on the Kansas City side, but Sacred City keeping their eyes on the prize really well, knocking Jessica Boom out on the outside and drawing her way back.
That was Talls with the exit hit in the drawback for Sacred City. Jessica Boom now fighting against a stagnant wall in between turns 3 and 4. Jessica Boom to the outside, jammer out now. Pink Freud back on the track for Sacred City. Jessica Boom through the pack, 5 points, Kansas City.
Laura Stabs for Sacred City going to the Derby Supply penalty box for a low block, falling in front of Jessica Boom there.
Pink Freud clear. That was a 4-5 point scoring pass. And 2 more points picked up by Jessica Boom at the tail end of that jam. Another scoring deluge.
Indeed it is. Look at that score right now. Kansas City 11, Sacred City at 28, 25, just under 26 minutes left in the first half of this game. Want to say thank you to Powerdyne, Cutting Edge Designs, Cutting Edge Performance from the Rydell family.
We will get our first looks at track rat jamming for Kansas City. Number 44, the forecloser for Sacred City. Forecloser goes inside, then out, now trying to go through the middle. Nice defense there as Enigma with the exit hit. Forecloser resets, gets a big hit on Tough Noogies, goes to the outside and clears. Lead jammer goes to Sacred City.
Track rat just caught in the middle of that mob of Sacred defense there coming out of turn 2. Doing a little star stash.
Kansas City blockers, defense in the back. Sacred City a little bit of offense through and forecloser. That's a 5-point scoring pass. Sacred City, nice job out front by number 113. Annie Anklebiter on the defense as track rat clears on her initial pass.
Annie Anklebiter, one of the strong blockers on the Sacred squad.
Now, unlike the first two jams, that was a quick hit it and quit it we see there. 5-0 jam in favor of Sacred as they extend their lead 33-11 as we are under 25 minutes left to play here in the first half.
Want to say thanks to Rydell Skates, RydellSkates.com. Made in the USA, made for Derby, Rydell Skates.
Well, and as talked about during the pregame, Kansas City not afraid to go with multiple jammers on their fourth right now as Case Close takes the track for the first time, pops through the pack. Lead jammer, Kansas City. Ariella Twister now clear of the pack for Sacred City, giving up less than half a track to Case Closed.
This is the first lead jam that Kansas City has gotten in this game so far.
That was an amazing apex jump at the end of that jam by Ariella Twister. She did stick the jump, but unfortunately after the fourth whistle blew, no points for an amazing effort. So that was a 1-0 jam in favor of Kansas City.
And we want to say thanks to Quick from the Rydell family. Quick bearings, when you want quality, think Quick.
Shock and Auburn taking a turn with the jammer cap for Sacred City. Opposite Mary Lou Wretched for Kansas City. Mary Lou Wretched trying to push on the inside there. She's working against Neil and Weep and Sassy Longlegs.
But it is Shock and Auburn taking that inside line, just squeaking by, getting out and getting lead for Sacred City.
And Mary Lou Wretched now clear of the pack on her initial pass, giving up a little less than half the track. As we see Annie Anklebiter reporting to the penalty box for Sacred City.
Shock and Auburn trying to call it off, but she draws a penalty, a forearm penalty. She's going to the Derby Supply penalty box. This is now a power jam in favor of Kansas City.
Kansas City going with a little bit of offense. Mary Lou Wretched tries to toe stop, dance on the inside rail, dances into the infield though, and a track cut penalty. That will free Shock and Auburn.
That's right, little jammer switcheroo. We have another 2-minute jam going on. Kansas City building that back wall coming into turn 3.
Forcing Sacred City to play offense from the front, inverse offense, some of the toughest to play. And now we've got a back block penalty that's going to send Shock and Auburn back to the penalty box this jam.
She's usually more of a relief jammer for Sacred City. I think that they may keep her in that position if this trend continues.
Rump Wrecker and Annie Mall up with some extremely active offense, trying to free Mary Lou Wretched on this scoring pass.
Kansas City drawing back at number three, Sassy Longlegs, trying to define the pack so that they can spring Mary Lou Wretched out of that wall that is not letting her move.
Rump Wrecker was trying to stop any ankle biter there, who has been a thorn in Mary Lou Wretched's side.
Shaka Nauburn back on the track, facing her own wall trouble, trying to get through, but she's pushing her way through on the outside.
Very constricted pack between turns one and two. That jam goes its full length. It looks like we had five more points for Kansas City, four more for Sacred City being held at the end of that jam.
That puts the score Kansas City 17, Sacred City 37, 21 minutes, 20 seconds left in the first period of this game.
Three jams in a row that Kansas City has had a slight edge in the point differential for those jams, slowly eking their way back into.
And on the fast girl start line, we see Pink Freud for Sacred City going up against Jessica Boom.
Pink Freud working out front. Pat getting drawn out as it enters turn one. And lead jammer goes to Sacred City.
That's right, coming out of turn two, and Kansas City bleeding some blockers. They have two going to the Derby Supply penalty box.
Jessica Boom being held in the front of the pack there. That's still her initial pass. Moves to the inside rail out of turn two, and she is clear on her initial. Pink Freud takes 4 points and calls off the jam. Well, Sacred City putting an end to that little Kansas City run there.
That's right. WFTDA wants to say thanks to Bont. You can check them out at bont.com. Lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable and customizable carbon fiber boots. Check them out on the internets.
3-2 pack advantage in favor of Sacred City to start this next jam as they send out four closer to the jam line. Track Rat jamming opposite her for Kansas City.
Solid back wall of Sacred on that start line as four closer meets the two remaining Kansas City blockers. And, oh, she is on her way to the penalty box for a back block. This is now a power jam for Kansas City.
Track Rat clears the pack on her initial pass. She is lead jammer for Kansas City. So now, Sacred City losing. Kneel and weep to the penalty box. Two on two, the blockers on the track, although one released for each team. Kansas City through the pack, 5 points for Track Rat.
Pack is stalled right there in the apex of turn two.
Four on two in the pack now in favor of Kansas City, which means an easy grand slam there for Track Rat. Although Foxy Brown now reporting to the penalty box for Kansas City.
That's right, it's a 3-on-2 pack in favor of Kansas City. Track Rat takes advantage. That sacred wall, the twofers barely split apart, and she just drove a shoulder through and was able to get through. Four closer back on the track and through on her initial pass for Sacred City.
Nice move out of the penalty box by four closer. Went untouched on the outside rail. Track Rat goes inside, scoots through, and picks up 4 points before calling off the jam for Kansas City. A 19. 19-0 jam in favor of Kansas City. Fans, we got ourselves a 5-point bout.
That's right. Sacred may have come out swinging, but 36 points for Kansas City, 41 for Sacred with just under 19 minutes left in the first period. And Kansas City has things to say, apparently. And I have a thing to say as well. We want to say thanks to S1 Helmets. Be a lifer, get a lifer, S1 Helmets.
Case closed for Kansas City. Ariella Twister for Sacred City, and it is Kansas City getting case closed through lead jammer.
Pack still hanging out by the pivot line as Ariella Twister gets out on her initial pass. Case closed, coming in and starting to scoring.
Nice offense by Bruiser going outside to in there. That helped pick up the 3 points for Kansas City.
Really good jammer awareness on that, too, calling it off just as Ariella Twister was coming in to try and score.
A back-and-forth bout to start here, Tara. We've got a good one.
Yeah, we do. You know what else is good? The WFTDA website, because you can go and get scores and recaps, brackets, and more about this weekend's games at Tournament Central, wftda.com/tournaments.
4-3 pack advantage in favor of Sacred City to start this jam. Pack nearing the exit of turn two, starting to be pushed along in the front there.
Kansas City blockers trying to stop Pink Freud on her forward trajectory. Now up to three, but she squeaks through on the inside. Gets lead for Sacred.
Nice job keeping her toe stops inbound on the inside rail now as Mary Lou Wretched with the star off. It has been passed, and it was successful as Rumprecker threw the pack clear on the initial.
Pink Freud, seeing that that is happening, gets through, gets her points, calls it off for Sacred.
You know, we've really had a back-and-forth bout up until this point. One team will establish a couple jams where the point differential is in their favor. And again, as we see here, Sacred City with a 4-0 win in that jam, stopping Kansas City's momentum. Again, trying to put a little bit of distance between the two.
I definitely see this game as the Walter Sobchak of games. It's the calmer than you are, calmer than you are. And that's, I think that's really going to come into play as this game continues.
Well, we've got four closer jamming for Sacred City. Number four, Jessica Boom for Kansas City.
Look at that slow grinding pack just coming up to the pivot line.
And you can see foreclosure's lateral movement from that aerial shot there. Back and forth, inside to out, outside to in. Nice job maintaining inbound, spin around at the front there, and uses the outside rail to clear. Foreclosure's your lead jammer for Sacred City. And a track cut penalty called on Jessica Boom. Now it's a power jam for Sacred City.
Jessica Boom shaking her head as she's on her way to the Derby Supply penalty box. She did not like that call.
Foreclosure gets around the three defenders on the outside of turn two. She clears 5 points, scoring past Sacred City as she's coming around again.
So far, the jammer penalties. Sacred has 4 so far. Kansas City now up to 3.
Nice crash offense coming from the inside, opening that inside rail for Foreclosure. 5 points scoring past Sacred City.
Kansas City building a little braced wall in front as Foreclosure coming in. Jukes and jives to the outside.
Foreclosure, it looked like she had a hard time deciding which side to go to, inside or out there. Chose to go up the middle and hit her own blocker, but rolled to the outside and cleared on that scoring pass before calling off the jam.
There's nothing like a little friendly fire in these games. Kansas City with 39, Sacred City 60, just over 15 minutes left in the first half of this game. I want to say thank you to Fast Girl Skates. 8 years dedicated to making a faster you. Check them out on the internet at fastgirlskates.com.
Ariella Twister wearing the star for Sacred City. Case closed, jamming for Kansas City. Ariella Twister almost through on that inside rail. She gets recycled to the back, now goes to the outside. She's bumped out by Enigma as Ariella Twister had a huge inside rail through turn two to roll through lead jammer, Sacred City.
The case closed also out of the pack as well. Sacred City in the back. Nice apex jump by Ariella Twister. She lands it and calls it off. After picking up 4 points for Sacred City, 64 to Kansas City's 39.
So Sacred City now on a 23-0 run. As we are just about left with 14 minutes here in the first half of play.
And I see lined up on the Fast Girl Skates start line, number 23, Track Rat, going up against number 451, Shockin' Auburn.
Looks like we've got 3-on-3 in the pack to start.
And again, Sacred going for that back straight across wall that they love so much.
Sacred now getting their fourth blocker back, still choosing to go containment only.
Whoa, all of the falling out there on the outside line.
That was Accelerator taking out Shockin' Auburn there, who's now fighting against a braced two-wall at the front. Nice tripod set up by Kansas City.
Meanwhile, Track Rat facing that classic straight across wall there on the pivot line, and she's trying to pinball her way through.
Tall's doing a nice job of bridging the pack right there.
Shockin' Auburn squeaking through on the outside, jukes to the inside, picks up lead for Sacred City.
Accelerator to the penalty box for Kansas City. They're going to be down another blocker. Star stash by Kansas City. Track Rat still with the star in her hand. You can see there she's being moved almost to the outside by Sacred City. Enigma now up front, last line of defense, trying to hold back number 451, Shockin' Auburn, who instead decides to take the points and call off the jam.
And a good call, even though Sacred City doing a great job of containment, sometimes it's just better to nickel and dime and preserve the jammer energy. So In the first four jams of this game, it was Sacred in Sacred's favor, 33-12. And then in the next four jams, Kansas City, 23-8 points. And then in these past four jams, 27 points for Sacred City.
Well, Sacred City right now on a run. They have Pink Freud jamming. She's trying to push out the front of the pack. She does. Lead jammer goes to Sacred City. Jessica Boom wearing the star for Kansas City, being held up in the backfield. Nice job by Neil and Weep.
And again, those strong walls that Sacred City loves to build at the back of the pack, working to their advantage. Pink Freud coming through, coming along on the outside of turn two for a scoring pass.
Neil and Weep to the penalty box for Sacred City. As Jessica Boom clears on her initial pack for Kansas City, Foxy Brown back on the track for Kansas City.
Another scoring pass for Pink Freud, and Sacred City bumping up their score to 77 points to Kansas City's 39 with 11 minutes, 30 seconds left in the first half of this game. If you guys are enjoying this game, and you better be, I expect you to be, let us know via the Twitters with hashtag #TalkNumber2WFTDA.
By my estimation, a 36-0 run in favor of Kansas City right now. Four closer on the line for Sacred City. Opposite case closed for Kansas City.
Big mob of blockers there on the pivot line going into turn one. Kansas City in front trying to stop Forecloser. She's trying to juke back and forth, not finding any space.
Forecloser, one of those jammers that you almost need all four blockers to be able to stop, because Kansas City does have a 4-3 blocker advantage.
And they're using it to best effect, but Sacred City not doing so bad themselves, holding back, case closed. Forecloser gets out and gets lead for Sacred City.
She found room on the inside to work, and she cleared. And we now have case closed clear on her initial pass. Forecloser on the outside of turn two, trying to get through the pack, moves to the inside, shrugs off a hit from Lady Killshot, and calls off the jam, having picked up 3 points on that scoring pass.
And you can see that reflected in the score, 80 points to 39 points for Kansas City. Lead jammer status, Sacred has gotten 11 lead jammer calls, while Kansas City has only had 3 in this half. Wow.
Well, and that helps explain the 41-point difference as we near the 10-minute mark here in the first half. Track rat jamming again for Kansas City. Opposite Ariella Twister for Sacred City.
Both of them trying to go on that inside line. Ariella taking the friendly side, but then jukes to the not-so-friendly side on the outside. Both jammers having great difficulty getting through those respective walls.
Nice line defense by Neil and Weep there, and you see Neil and Weep then cycle back up to the front of the pack, trying to help keep Track Rat in the pack. Track Rat getting moved to the outside of turn one, and that allows Ariella Twister to skate through. Lead jammer Sacred City.
Sacred doing really well with the distraction tactics in this game so far. Their jammer is able to squeak through and pick up lead. And again,
oh no, a track cut penalty on Ariella Twister. She tried to call off the jam from the infield. She'll report to the penalty box. We now have a power jam for Kansas City.
And this is the second time this has happened to Sacred City in this game, where they thought they were cool and were able to call off the jam. And no, denied. It's now a power jam in favor of Kansas City. That's 5 points at Track Rat just scored for Kansas City.
Nice cycle up by Rose Villain, trying to keep Track Rat in the pack. Eventually had to let her go. 4-2 pack advantage for Kansas City, and they have the only jammer out there. There's Enigma up to play offense. Track Rat, though, goes to the unfriendly side and clears on a 5-point scoring pass.
Nice offense work by Kansas City on that pass. They definitely want to start getting all of the points.
I was interested to see what Kansas City was going to do when they had set up 2 blockers in front of the Sacred blockers getting ready for that. But then they all moved to the back and played a little more traditional offense. Ariella Twister, one to beat up front. She goes to the outside and clears. That's a 4-point scoring pass for Sacred City. And Enigma now with the star for Kansas City. She is clear of the pack.
Ariella Twister just doing another apex jump. So far, up until this jam, Kansas City was held scoreless for 7 jams.
And Kansas City taking the advantage in that one. It looks like 10-6. I don't think there were any more points being held.
The scoreboard says 49 points for Kansas City, 86 for Sacred City. 7 minutes, 39 seconds left in the first half of this game. And we want to say thank you to Adam Skates for sponsoring this weekend's championship games. Adam Skates, proud partner of the WFTDA then and now. And this is a team timeout. And it is brought to you by Spank Alley Armbands, fully adjustable, fully customizable armbands from Australia. Say no to Texta. Visit Spank Alley at spankalley.com.au.
So this Sacred City's first team timeout, the first team timeout that we've had this bout so far.
And it's interesting that I think, again, this is the Walter Sobchak idea of staying calm. They were getting some blocker penalties, having only two of the track at once, and we can see how that can spiral out of control for any team, but Sacred especially wants to keep the lid on that, and so they are going to calm it down. So far, the penalty count, Sacred is in the lead. They're not only in the lead with points, they're in the lead with penalties. They have 17 to Kansas City's 12.
Getting work done.
Just hitting all the notes there.
That's right.
Team timeout is over. Teams coming back to the line. And look at this, Kansas City deciding to take the back line on the Fast Girl Skate start line.
Well, we've got 44, the foreclosure out for Sacred City. Opposite number four, Jessica Boom. Not the first time we've seen this matchup today.
And surely not the last.
Man, Sacred City almost caught sleeping there. Jessica Boom thought she had the outside rail all to herself. Knocked to the outside, though, and Forecloser takes advantage. Lead jammer goes to Sacred City.
And the pack has not moved off the jammer line very much. Forecloser hip-hopping her way through the pack, picking up points on her first scoring pass.
Jessica Boom clear on her initial pass for Kansas City. Forecloser checking in with her bench. Make sure to call off the jam. Oh, and a back block penalty leveled at the last second of that jam against Jessica Boom. She will return to the penalty box. That is her third jammer penalty this half.
Wow. Sacred playing a really good controlled game. Kansas City a little more uneven than I expected in this game so far. Very, very interesting, I must say. So 90 points for Sacred City, 49 for Kansas City, 6 minutes, 28 seconds left in the first period. And we start out this power jam with Ariella Twister.
And Ariella Twister picking up some great defense from Neil and Weeb, going inside to out, help Springer from the pack. Lead jammer, Sacred City. I am loving the offense that Sacred City is showing here. As again, you see Neil and Weep and Rose Villain attacking the pack. That was enough distraction offense to help free their jammer, Ariella Twister, another 5-point scoring pass.
Kansas City back in full strength blocker-wise there in turn two. Ariella Twister hitting that wall. No apex jump for her on this one.
Neil and Weep up to play a little bit of offense, then notices the opposing jammer coming out of the box, heads back to play defense, and Ariella Twister clears for 5.
That's right. She did the unrolling of the carpet there on the outside line. She gets knocked to the infield, having to reset.
Not resetting too quickly, sort of taking your time there a little bit, but it paid off perfectly. Had one blocker to beat, and she cleared for 4 points as Jessica Boom clears on her initial pass, and the jam is called.
Sacred City breaking the century mark, 104 points to Kansas City's 49. They've been held scoreless for quite a few jams now, with just over 5 minutes left in the first half of this game. And we want to say, talk about the recognized tournaments program. You can check that out on WFTDA.com/events. The first round of 2016 WFTDA recognized tournaments have been announced, so visit that website and check it out.
We've got case closed jamming for Kansas City opposite Pink Floyd for Sacred City. Pink Floyd working on the outside. You can see all of Kansas City's blockers there at the front of the pack. Two left to beat up front. Oh, and we've got a jammer penalty. We now have a power jam for Kansas City. Case closed, your lead jammer as a forearm leveled against Pink Floyd. She'll report to the penalty box.
And Sacred City at a blocker disadvantage to boot. So, but they did just get Neil and Weep back from the Derby Supply penalty box. So they're setting up a braced wall in the front of the pack.
Lady Killshot and Bruiser trying to play offense for Case Closed. Case Closed going to the outside, staying inbounds. No, moved out of bounds. She's going to be recycled by Blushy Lushy.
Nice work by Sacred City. Now they set up that tripod in the back of the pack. Kansas City going in for some distraction tactics.
Annie Mall out of the penalty box. Thought she might play a little bit of offense there. She rejoins the pack. Numbers back for both teams, and we got a big hit on the far side of the track. Case closed, going down hard on the exit of turn three.
She was able to call it off.
Exit of turn two, excuse me.
And it looked like, from our vantage point, that she really got the wind knocked out of her.
Well, and there was a definite crowd reaction on the far side of the track from that hit.
So in the last 10 jams, Kansas City has scored 20 points. Sacred City has scored 59. Which is interesting. That's Kansas City's score right now. It's 59, but okay. So that very interesting stats there. Yeah, Sacred, despite the little bit of back and forth, Sacred just staying dominant so far in this game. And looking at the penalties so far, Annie Anklebiter is on 4 trips to the
wow.
Derby Supply box already. Now, she was one. She fouled out of a few games during playoffs, if I remember right. Foxy Brown is the big penalty drawer for Kansas City with 3.
And there's your look at the Bont inside whiteboard. You can see those penalties Tara describing. In the meantime, case closed was being tended to by the medical staff. She skated back to the bench on her own powers, though under the watch of the medical staff. So she'll be checked on there. Now remember, that was not an injury that ended that jam, as you pointed out, Tara. She was able to call that jam off from the floor. So case closed will still be available to be in the rotation for jammers for Kansas City.
That's right. She doesn't have to sit out the required 3 jams for a medical call-off because there was no medical call-off.
Right. We are on an official timeout.
And that means we can have a few more sponsor messages. We'd have a few shout outs. Let's do some shout outs and thank yous. We want to say thanks and shouting out to Sin City Skates, 5-on-5 Magazine, Something Inked, Derby Central, and our fabulous hosts, the Minnesota Roller Girls. I don't know if you had a chance to check out their merch table downstairs.
I have not yet, no.
They have an awesome shirt that says, "The road to hell is paved with sport court." It is the most.
Okay, that's pretty good.
That's going to sell out by midday tomorrow at the latest, I imagine. But yeah, the legendary Roy Wilkins Auditorium is really, I've heard so much about this venue for years and years and years, and it has lived up to the hype.
No, it definitely has. It's a very pretty venue here, and we've got a good number of people here already for the early morning bouts. I'm told that this is going to fill in more and more as the day goes on, and I have no doubt about this. If you're in the area and you've got a chance to come down, you definitely need to check it out.
Well, especially the next game after this one, we get into the D1
That's right.
games, and the next game has Angel City Derby Girls from Los Angeles, California, going up against the Rat City Roller Girls from Seattle, Washington.
It's going to be such a good bout.
Oh, my God. Especially with, we're waiting to hear what the official review was about.
970 clockwise. To use their official review as a timeout, play will resume in 1 minute.
So we have an expulsion from Sacred City. This is where the penalty trouble is going to come in. So Kansas City is asking for an expulsion on Narnar Jinx for a high block, an egregious. Oh, and she's gone. She is skating off the track as we speak.
Well, and that's a loss for Sacred City, seeing as Narnar Jinx had only been to the box 1 time so far.
Yes, and I bet...
Yeah, 10 jams, 1 trip to the box, and they have lost their services for the remainder of that bout. That could prove to be a big loss for Sacred City.
It could be, though. They do have a reputation for all of their blockers just being heavy-duty blockers, so it'll be interesting to see see how that goes. So Kansas City's official review is being used as a timeout right now to kind of gather themselves and think about how they can take advantage of Narnar Jinx's sudden departure.
Well, Kansas City did have a 10-0 advantage in that last jam, so putting some points on the board for themselves now as they find themselves down by 45. With 3.5 minutes left to play in the first half, we've got Mary Lou Wretched lined up on the jam line for Kansas City. Opposite number 44, the forecloser.
And in the first time of this game, we see the pack starting on that pivot line.
That is the fastest this pack has been to the apex of turns one and two all bout.
Mary Lou Wretched definitely trying to take advantage of that. Sacred City trying to shut her down with their partnerships of Talls and Kneel and Weep at the front.
Kansas City going mostly defense in the back against Forecloser. Forecloser pushing out the front. Enigma, last line of defense for Kansas City. Trying to hold back Forecloser. Can she push her to the outside? No, Forecloser. Forecloser trying to push forward. She does lead jammer. Mary Lou Wretched, though, out right behind her.
Look at Forecloser. Forecloser not trying to chase her. She's going to let her wear herself out. She's waiting for that call off just as Mary Lou Wretched hits the back of the pack. And that pack is speeding up.
That's right. Pushing the pace of the pack there. Nice job. Forecloser finally getting the word from the bench. Calls off the jam.
And we want to clarify that Narnar Jinx's expulsion was for direction of gameplay. Very egregious direction of gameplay penalty. That still doesn't change the fact that she's out of the game. And it's just the first half, so it'll be interesting to see how this continues for both teams. And again, another pivot line start.
Well, and we have the two leading scorers for each team. Track Rat for Kansas City with 29 points so far. Ariella Twister with 47 for Sacred City.
Track Rat getting out and getting lead for Kansas City. Ariella Twister also making her way out of the pack. And again, the jammers beginning to race it, but the pack trying to speed up. And Kansas City wants to speed it up. Sacred wants to slow it down, but Track Rat getting through, picking up all 4 points.
1 point picked up by Ariella Twister before the fourth whistle sounded. So only a 3-point advantage in that jam for Kansas City.
1 minute, 30 seconds left in this first half of gameplay. 63 points for Kansas City, 105 for Sacred. So Sacred, they're getting a little stalled in their points.
Well, and interesting to notice here, Tara, as soon as Kansas City started moving up to the pivot line, that's when they started putting more points on the board than Sacred City. We'll see if this trend continues.
That jammer momentum can make a world of difference, and that is basically what Kansas City is doing. They're going old school.
All defense in the back right there. Case closed, making some headway at the front of the pack. She goes to the outside, now moves back to the inside. Oh, jammer on jammer hit, but no, it is Sacred City getting Shock and Auburn through first lead jammer. Case closed, spins from the inside to the out. She's going to try and get through the pack on the outside as she moves back to the in. A back block penalty now against 451. Shock and Auburn will send her to the penalty box.
That's right. She sent Rump Wrecker flying to the floor. So we'll see what Kansas City is able to do with this. Sacred City bleeding skaters to the Derby Supply penalty box right now.
Case closed, star in hand right now, trying to make forward progress, getting a little bit of offense from Lady Killshot. And now that's Tough Noogies also with a little bit of inverse offense from the front.
Tough Noogies has been very interesting to watch in this game. She is very determined to do all she can to break apart Sacred City's walls in this game.
Rose Villain and Talls on the recycle there, and another big hit by Kneel and Weep. Kneel and Weep has been everywhere on this track so far this bout.
I love watching her block. She has been amazing all season long.
That was a great penalty kill by Sacred City as they've now got their jammer Shock and Auburn out on the track. Star Stash Kansas City. And oh, nice exit hit, but a low block for her troubles. Rump Wrecker clear on her initial pass.
That's right. That Star Stash working in Kansas City's favor. Jammer penalties so far. Kansas City with 4, Sacred with 7.
Nice defense by Enigma at the front of the pack, but she gets whistled for a penalty and reports to the penalty box for Kansas City. 4 points picked up by Kansas City as they call off the jam. And fans, we are now at halftime.
That's right. We have a halftime score, 67 points for Kansas City, Sacred 109. That is a decent lead, but it is not a comfortable lead. Sacred is going to have to stay on their toes, especially with the way that Kansas City has played in the past few jams.
Well, 42 points separating the two teams for Kansas City. That's two-thirds of their output in the first half. That's going to be quite a hill to climb in the second half for them, but we saw Kansas City make some changes. They moved their blockers up to the pivot line. That started to help them put some points on the board and get some momentum going against Sacred City. What's going to be interesting is what happens with both of these teams as they go back and talk during halftime. Tara, I'm really excited to see what the changes are going to be in the second half.
And it's definitely fun to speculate what those changes could be. Is Sacred able to adjust to playing this old school game, as it were? They have been around for a long time, but not as long as Kansas City. Kansas City seems to be just a little more moldable to these different strategies. And despite Sacred's tenacity, and they practice with the Bay Area home teams a lot, and so they know they have a lot of things in their toolbox, as we like to say.
Exactly.
But it's definitely going to end the penalty count is definitely going to come into play for Sacred City.
Well, and we'll talk about that a little bit later, fans. We got about 13 minutes left of halftime. Please be joining us for the second half, and we're going to kick it over to some sponsors. Welcome back, Derby fans, wherever you may be. We are here at the 2015 International WFTDA Championships, live from the legendary Roy Wilkins Auditorium in St. Paul, Minnesota, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Minnesota Roller Girls. Tara, what a first half we had.
An interesting back and forth of point scoring and styles going on. And as we see on the scoreboard, Sacred City from Sacramento, California, ahead with 109 points compared to Kansas City's 67 points. And it was interesting at the end of the first half what Kansas City decided to do, because of their point differential in the negative.
Right, they moved their blockers up to the pivot line to start and then went on a 22-5 run to end out the half. So
the last five jams of the half, that is what they did. Yes.
Very interesting, and we'll see if that continues to play out in the second half. Let's cover some penalties real quick. For Kansas City, 19 total penalties, 15 of those blocker penalties, 4 of those were jammer penalties. Enigma leading the team with 4, followed by Jessica Boom and Foxy Brown with 3 each. On Sacred City's side of the ledger, Narnar Jinx was expelled for a direction of gameplay, which we'll get back to in just a second. She was expelled in the first half. Blushy Lushy with 5 penalties, Annie Anklebiter and Talls both with 4, a total of 27 for the team, 20 of those for blockers, 7 of those for jammers. But let's go back to Narnar Jinx for just a second.
So on the Twitters, hashtag talk to WFTDA, it was brought up for a fan fairly new, what was the expulsion penalty for and what does it mean? Tracy Williams was asking about that, and Bitches Brews said, it's a good time to talk about procedure and consider whether that action will affect Sunday's game too.
Well, first of all, Sacred City needs to be victorious here in order for it to have any chance of impacting Sunday's game. But that is a meeting that will be held after the bout to discuss the level of egregiousness of that hit and whether it warrants a small suspension. And we have seen that before in tournament play. It's not often that it happens, but that could cost Sacred City. Narnar Jinx, who in the first half up till she was expelled, had skated in 9 jams and had only 1 trip to the box at that point.
And reiterating just the overall penalty count, 27 to Kansas City's 19, Sacred does have to keep a lid on those penalties as we come back into the second half.
Forecloser out jamming for Sacred City opposite Mary Lou Wretched for Kansas City. Sacred City losing number 17, Rhodes Warrior, to the penalty box.
Teams still, they're coming out of turn 2. Mary Lou Wretched getting out, getting lead for Kansas City.
Right behind her, though, Forecloser. Blockers already set up, waiting the arrival of the jammers on the far side of the track. Mary Lou Wretched crashing into the pack. Forecloser crashing right behind her. Forecloser now with the initiative up front in the jam, moves to the inside, and she clears first. That's a four-point scoring pass matched by Kansas City's Mary Lou Wretched for four. She calls off the jam, so 0 point differential to start the second half.
Yeah, kind of a too little too late on the part of that call off for Kansas City, even though they did get points. They're still behind 71-113, and may have behooved Mary Lou Wretched to call it off before forecloser was able to get around her on that sacred back wall. But, you know, different strokes for different folks.
Jessica Boom out with the star for Kansas City. Ariella Twister, leading scorer in this bout, 48 points to her credit, jamming for Sacred City.
And that pivot line start, as we saw at the end of the last period, coming into play. Ariella Twister getting hit to the inside.
That was by Enigma, who did a really nice job on that hit. But Ariella Twister recovers, finds the inside rail, and clears. Lead jammer goes to Sacred City.
Jessica Kaboom working on her initial pass. She keeps getting recycled to the back. Those Northern Californians do love their ecology and recycling.
Ariella Twister not afraid to go right through the middle of the defense as she cleared on that five-point scoring pass. Back again, starting on the inside, moves to the out and clears on another easy 5 points.
But we do have the pivot for Sacred City going to the penalty box. That is Rose Villain. That is her second time to the Derby Supply penalty box.
Jessica Boom now clear the pack for Kansas City. Kansas City losing Enigma to the penalty box. A low block out front. And that is Enigma's fifth trip to the penalty box. It's still very, very early in the second half here. It'd be interesting to see whether Kansas City chooses to have her ride the pines a little bit more, or they're going to continue to send her out.
Yeah, especially because despite the penalty count, she's really effective.
Right.
And that's the tricky part.
Well, sometimes when you have blockers that aren't afraid to do the dirty work, which is, you know, the offense or the one-on-one defense, you know, they get the penalties to go along with it.
Case closed. Pink Freud meeting up on the jammer line for this jam. And case closed, getting out and getting lead for Kansas City.
Rump Wrecker, a little bit of offense on the inside, helping to spring her as Pink Freud now clear on her initial pass, giving up less than a quarter of the track. Small pack in turn two. Hit it and quit it for Kansas City. 3 points for Kansas City. It looks like 2 points for Sacred.
I see 1 point going up on the board for Kansas City. So 74 points for Kansas City, 129 for Sacred, 26 minutes, 35 seconds left in this game. And we are continuing the pivot line starts. Kansas City owning that pivot line there, 3-on-3 in the pack.
Foreclosure jamming again for Sacred City, opposite track rat. Sacred City getting Kneel and Weep back out of the penalty box. 4-on-3 blocker advantage in favor of Sacred City. Foreclosure trying to push out the defense at the front of the pack, gets knocked to the outside, goes back to the end. Lead jammer, Sacred City.
Track rat fighting that back Sacred wall, trying to find her way around.
Kneel and Weep there again on defense for Sacred City. Sassy long legs as well.
Track rat trying to find the friendly side, and unfortunately Sacred says there is no friendly side for you.
Mayhem Myers through the penalty box for Kansas City as Foreclosure coming around for another scoring pass. Track rat still working on the initial. Foreclosure against Enigma at the front of the pack. Enigma one-on-one as we've seen before. There we go. Foreclosure rolls to the inside. Outside, excuse me, and she is clear on another scoring pass.
We have a depleted pack. Two blockers on the track for Sacred. Only three for Kansas City as Foreclosure comes in for another scoring pass.
On Foreclosure on a power jam right now. Mayhem Myers out of the penalty box for Kansas City.
That's a track cut that a track rat did there, earning her spot in the Derby Supply penalty box.
Tough Noogie stand-up block there, trying to...
Oh, Tough Noogies.
Trying to hold back Foreclosure.
Tough Noogies and Rose Villain going at it there, too. I always love those revenge hits.
Nice job by Mayhem Myers up front, getting a couple more hits on Foreclosure as she leaves the pack on another scoring pass. Sacred City with a 15-0 advantage in that jam.
And for closer, I always like, she has the what I call the Affleck look. It's just water off a duck's back. No matter what people are trying to throw on her, she just patiently tries her best to get through it as calmly as possible, not let it rattle her at all.
Ariella Twister out for a power start for Sacred City, getting offense on the outside. That's number 94 rolling to the inside. Nice job by Talls. Oh, but a forearm penalty is going to send Ariella Twister to the penalty box. Track Rat now free. That means Ariella Twister going to sit for the full 30 seconds.
That's right. Track Rat was on her way out as Ariella Twister was on her way into that penalty box. Track Rat ping-ponging her way through, or pinballing her way through. Nice offense by Kansas City. They're trying to swarm that sacred wall.
Accelerator trying to push from the inside. Unfortunately, Track Rat going to the unfriendly side on the out first. Little inverse offense coming from Lady Killshot, and Track Rat doing a nice job staying in bounds through turn three. Lead jammer, Kansas City.
That was a lot of work just to get that lead jammer designation, but totally worth it right now for Kansas City.
Well, one of the strengths we've seen from Sacred City is their power, or is their penalty kill, and they have done a great job in this game so far as we see Ariella Twister out of the penalty box and clear on her initial pass.
That's right. She was invisible as she went through on that inside line, and that forces the jam call off.
It really helped that Ariella Twister went low as she skated into turn three there. It may have helped obfuscate her a little bit from the opposing blockers there.
It's amazing sometimes how those very basic skills that we all get yelled at for newbies about staying low is actually matters. And we have an official timeout or official review being called by Sacred City.
So we're going to go ahead and kick it over to some sponsors for just a moment, and we will come back and let you know exactly what this official review is about.
Or not.
All right, so we mentioned the Story Slam after party. We got two after parties. Also tonight at the Amsterdam Bar and Hall, 6 West 6th Street, featuring a full range of spirits, cocktails, quality beer, and a delicious Dutch-inspired menu.
Dutch?
Dutch. Huh. 90s cover band You Oughta Know will be followed by
Sacred
DJ.
City has requested an official review of Kansas City's jam call-off, stating that the cover was removed, therefore the call-off was illegal.
All right, so for those you may or may not have heard, our head referee, Cirrhosis, saying that the review was for Kansas City's call-off. They are saying that the star cap was not on the jammer when she called it off, and thus it should be an illegal call-off.
And that is... So we're trying to hear the house call and getting an explanation from Tootie Tune Whistle all at the same time. What have we learned, Mike Checks?
Not a lot, unfortunately. I would really like to bring you more information than I'm able to bring you right this second. We were unable to hear what the clarification was on the official review. It sounded like the cap may have fallen off, was not taken off on purpose, but we unfortunately did not get a clear clarification. We will get you that clarification as soon as we possibly can.
Considering that there are two jammers on the track, I would say that Sacred lost that official review.
I would guess that you're right. Sacred City losing Rose Villain to the penalty box now. Case closed. Jammer for Kansas City out of the pack. First is lead, and she calls off the jam. No points scored by either team.
She had Pink Floyd right behind her. She didn't want to take that chance of Sacred taking advantage and getting yet more points and increasing their lead, because already they are at 144 points to Kansas City's 77 with just over 22 minutes left in this game. So The reason why Sacred lost that review was that the helmet cover fell off. It was not removed, so the lead jammer status was retained and the call-off was legal.
Well, and you were absolutely right then, Tara. So we've got now on the track the forecloser jamming for Sacred City opposite Rump Wrecker for Kansas City. And the forecloser out front. Exit hit on the opposing blocker there. Nice touch and lead jammer, Sacred City.
I love those hits like that. It's like, oh yeah, we'll take this as I come through and get lead jammer.
Forecloser getting some offense from number 27, Laura Stabs. Now goes to the outside. Oh, push to the out. No, track cut penalty on the forecloser. She will report to the penalty box. Power jam, Kansas City.
She's usually so good about keeping her skates in bounds.
Sorry to interrupt. Short-lived power jam there as Rump Wrecker whistled for a back block penalty.
Another two-minute jam since both jammers have gone to the box. Both jammers now back on the track. The teams are setting up right behind the start line.
Well, and we've got everybody on the track now. Four on four in the pack. Rump Wrecker being moved to the outside.
And Forecloser just getting knocked to the ground on the outside of turn one. She tries to reset and is just meeting Kansas City blockers the entire way.
Interesting to see that Sacred City dropping two blockers back to play defense in the front. Had two blockers up to play offense, but it's Kansas City getting a Rump Wrecker through first. That's a four-point scoring pass for Kansas City.
Forecloser being cautious. Looks like she is yelling for assistance from her teammates.
Gets stood up by Foxy Brown. And Rump Wrecker moved to the inside. Tons of hits going on as the pack stringing out in the front straightaway.
That's right. They're reconstituting themselves in between the start line and the pivot line. And jammers and bodies are just flying all over the track. Rump Wrecker getting the business, as they like to say, by number 94, Talls. And Forecloser not attacking that Kansas City defense at all. She's just being, again, Aflac, just water off a duck's back. Sacred still in the lead with 149 points. Kansas City chipping away at that up to 85.
Well, an interesting one of the penalties that happened is there were a few in that jam. Blushy Lushy whistled for her sixth now. And keep in mind, we're just inside 20 minutes left in the second half, so one skater expelled and one sitting on six penalties right now. Sacred City's got to start watching those penalties.
And number one, Neelan Weep with five penalties.
Yep, Ariella Twister jamming for Sacred.
And she goes out on a track cut. This is now a power jam in favor of Jessica Boom and Kansas City.
For Ariella Twister, that is her third trip to the penalty box.
And that is the 10th jammer penalty that Sacred has accrued in this game compared to Kansas City 6.
Jessica Boom working up front. Nice job against Annie Anklebiter. 5-point scoring pass for Kansas City.
Kansas City at full strength in the back, trying to stop Blushy Lushy from rejoining her teammates on the track.
I thought Jessica Boom was actually going to limbo under that block for just a second, the way that she started to go down.
That would have been interesting.
Certainly would have been, but she did not. She is able to clear the pack on another 5-point scoring pass as Ariella Twister out of the penalty box for Sacred City and around the outside, clears on her initial easily. More whistles down.
Wow, Sassy Longlegs falling small there on the outside of turn three, but there were still some somersaults going on over her.
Looked like it might have been a low block penalty whistled against Neelan Weep. That will be her sixth.
Oh, dear, yeah, Ooh. She's tied up with Blushy Lushy in penalty counts. Again, this is classic Sacred City right now where the penalties start to add up in that second half.
Well, and look out now. Kansas City starting to make a little bit of noise. They've closed the difference to 50, a 14-0 advantage in that last jam. We'll see if they can keep the momentum going with Case Closed jamming for them opposite Pink Floyd for Sacred City.
And again, they're going old school with that pivot line start, allowing the jammers to have more momentum as they hit the pack.
Case Closed was almost free. Got through on the inside that time. Lead jammer goes to Kansas City. Pink Floyd being held up in the backfield. Nice swarming defense by Annie Mall there.
The return of Annie Mall.
Oh, and a track cut penalty against Pink Floyd. This is exactly what Sacred City did not want to see. Case Closed through the pack on another 5-point scoring pass. Kansas Kansas City with the momentum right now.
Kansas City with 23 overall penalties to Sacred City's 40.
Annie Mall trying to get some offense with Bam Myers on the outside. Case closed, working against Sassy Longlegs.
And Sassy Longlegs getting pushed out as well, but Case Close still having a reset behind.
Great inverse offense. Case Close taking advantage of Ma'am Myers.
Case Close taking a knee. She manages to get out. That is five more points for Kansas City.
Tough noogies to the penalty box, though.
Pink Freud back on the track for Sacred.
And look at that. Kneel and Weep again on the offense, helping to spring her jammer. Nice job by Kneel and Weep.
Case Close breaking through for another 4 points. Kansas City breaking the century mark, 113 points, stalling Sacreds, who have 149 with 16 minutes, 24 seconds left in this game.
Back-to-back 14-0 advantages for Kansas City, 28-0 run, and team timeout, Sacred City. Can't say I'm surprised that we're seeing that, Tara.
That's right, and this team timeout is brought to you by Spank Alley Armbands. Bands. Say no to Texta. Visit spankalley.com.au. Those wonderful Australian peoples. And I just noticed Kneel and Weep on her seventh penalty.
Well, that is exactly what the Bont inside whiteboard is showing us. Kneel and Weep will not be skating anymore today for Sacred City.
Now, again, remember in Sacred's game against Nashville, they were in the lead. They lost three players to foul outs, and they lost in that last jam, but they, because of a power jam, it's they're following their MO, as it were, at this point. So in the first four jams of the second half, Sacred's scoring was 35-7. In the last five jams of this half, Kansas City is scoring 39-5. Wow.
Ariella Twister being sent out to hopefully stem that tide. Leading scorer of all jammers with 62 so far this bout. Her opposition, Track Rat, leading point getter for Kansas City with 36 so far.
Track Rat hitting that back wall of Sacred going into the apex of turns one and two. And it's Ariella Twister that makes it out and gets lead for Sacred City.
Kansas City losing their pivot to the penalty box. That's AK 47 Lady kill shot. Oh, but a nice job of Track Rat. No, did not stay in bounds. Track cut penalty against Track Rat. Power jam Sacred City.
And the pack is reconstituting itself going into turn three as Ariella Twister races out on the outside, picking up five more points for Sacred City.
Sacred City does a great job when they are in a power jam, and they also do a great job of penalty killing, and that is why they still have this lead in this bout. As you see, Ariella Twister through the pack again, five more points. This is now a 15-0 run by Sacred.
Four blockers for Sacred, three for Kansas City right now. Oh, Ariella Twister hitting that back wall.
Oh, Ariella Twister thought she was pushed into that block, but instead she's getting the back block penalty. Now we have a power jam for Kansas City.
Oh, my gosh.
All the things.
All the things are happening, and I don't know about anybody else. I don't need my entire seat. I'm just using the edge.
Kansas City losing tough noogies due to direction of play penalty. She's going to report to the penalty box for 30 seconds. That is her third penalty this bout.
Indeed.
Track Rat being held up in turn four again. Great penalty kill defense by Sacred City. Track Rat finally cleared. That was her initial pass for Kansas City.
That was Calamity Payne and Rose Villain doing the dirty work for Sacred on that pass. Very nice job.
Ariella Twister now trying to re-enter the pack. Kansas City blocker's going to drag her as far back as possible. Meanwhile, Track Rat at the front of the pack trying to make way on her own. Ariella Twister frees herself from the back of the pack, and she is clear. 5 points scoring past Sacred City. 4 points, excuse me.
Big pile up there in the apex of turn one right at the end of that jam. 116 points for Kansas City, 168 for Sacred City, just over 14 minutes left in this game. Oh.
every time it seems like Kansas City is starting to make headway, there's one or two jams that Sacred City manages to put together with a large enough point differential that it gives them room to breathe again.
The back and forth in this game has been phenomenal
so far.
And we have a battle of the fours again. Jessica Boom versus the four closer.
Jessica Boom trying to will herself to lead jammer status there. Almost clears the pack, but that is great lockdown defense at the front of the pack. That is 67 Rose Villain and 94 Talls again. They've been working together well so far this bout.
Four closer taking the outside. She gets out and gets lead for Sacred City.
94 Talls to the penalty box for Sacred City. Jessica Boom trying to go on the outside. Toe stop, stay in bounds. Absorbs a couple hits, including one by Four Closer that drops Jessica Boom. Four Closer through on a 5-point scoring pass. Holy cow.
Oh my goodness, yeah. When Four Closer goes all out, she ain't kidding around. And look at her just going back and forth, twirling along on the outside, just barely staying in bounds, and now taking a fall towards the apex.
Laura Stabs really put it to Jessica Boom before she could clear the pack for Kansas City. And now Four Closer on a low block penalty will report to the penalty box. Power jam Kansas City.
Oh my goodness, that is her third penalty, Four Closer's third penalty in this game.
Laura Stabs making herself a personal thorn in the side of Jessica Boom this jam. That was the second big exit hit by her this jam. And now Tall's in the backfield with the same type of maneuver.
Yeah, again, even though Sacred definitely has their favorite blockers, all of their blockers are very good at what they do.
Jessica Boom is just getting leveled out there right now. And you see, she is not wanting to take it. Forearm penalty for her frustrations as she will report to the penalty box.
Forecloser was already standing in the Derby Supply penalty box, and she chooses to take the long way around as she comes back onto the track.
Well, and with just 10 seconds left in the jam, who can blame her? No need to pick up a penalty right here.
Especially with the score differential where it is right now in Sacred's favor.
Though I will give her credit. She started accelerating through that straightaway like she might be trying to catch Kansas City sleeping and maybe sneak a point or two off.
She's sneaky.
Yeah.
I like that.
So we've got our score, 176, Sacred City, Kansas City, 121. Inside 11 and a half minutes left to play in the second half.
And again, the jammer penalty count, Kansas City is at 8, Sacred City 13.
4-3 pack advantage for Kansas City to start. Power start though for Sacred City. And again, we see Ariella Twister with a small corner jump there. She clears lead jammer.
Really impressive that she's able to do that while the pack is going as fast as it was on that initial pass.
Ariella Twister with a jammer on jammer bump. Jessica Boom though clears on her initial pass.
Oh, big hit by Lady Killshot as Ariella Twister coming out of that pack. Ariella Twister able to shake it off and keep going.
I'm wondering if we're going to see Sacred City continue to push this jam since we've seen Jessica Boom run into some penalty problems the last couple times she's had the star. Oh, wow.
Oh,
nice move by Ariella Twister there and draws the track cut penalty. Jessica Boom with another jammer penalty. And if it was Sacred City's intention of getting another penalty on her, it paid off.
Very nice work by Ariella Twister on that. Jessica Boom finally making her way to the Derby Supply penalty box very slowly.
Rose Villain also skating into the penalty box for Sacred City. Ariella Twister looks like she's going to the outside, fakes to the end, keeps her toe stops in bounds. Knocked down to the inside, decides to call off the jam after picking up 2 points on that scoring pass. And it looks like we have a team timeout being called by Kansas City.
And again, the team timeouts are sponsored by our friends in Australia, Spank Alley Armbands. They are fully adjustable, fully customizable armbands. Say no to Texta. Check them out online at spankalley.com.au. And that was interesting at the end of that last jam where Ariella Twister was very patiently coming up and not trying to just bulldoze through that wall. She doesn't want to get any more jammer penalties because Sacred has more than enough on their side.
Right.
They got to keep it clean with just under 10 minutes left in this game. They don't want to pull in this game what they did in the final game of playoffs.
And as you can see on the Bont Inside whiteboard there, number four, Jessica Boom, on the left-hand side of your screen. It shows her with five trips to the box so far. The last one, of course, coming in that last jam. She leads all jammers with five box trips. Ariella Twister with four for Sacred City.
In the last three jams, Sacred has been on a points tear with 43 to Kansas City's 12.
So our 1 minute team timeout now coming to its close as we see Pink Freud out to jam for Sacred City. She's got 24 points so far this game.
Kansas City setting up their four wall, not quite at the pivot line, but close enough. It gives Pink Freud enough momentum to try and break them up. But Kansas City's doing a really good job of maintaining the braced wall in front. Bridging out. Pink Freud still trying to find some space to get out.
And that's Enigma at the front of the pack, who we've seen as a great last line of defense for Kansas City.
She's kind of great at everything in this game.
Rose Villain out of the penalty box for Sacred City. Forearm penalty whistled on the far side of the track. And we have a back block penalty going against Pink Freud. Jessica Boom out of the penalty box and clear the pack on her initial pass.
She is not being indicated as lead jammer, so we're going to assume this is a two-minute jam. Nice offense by Kansas City as...
Direction of gameplay penalty whistled against someone there.
Now that's on the Kansas City side. Oh, that is an...
That is Rump Wrecker.
That is Rump Wrecker, yes.
That's right. And Jessica Boom stays in bounds, coming through turn four, 5 points, scoring past Kansas City, but Pink Freud out of the penalty box and back on the track for Sacred City.
Calamity Payne throwing in some offense as Pink Freud hits the pack. She manages to stay in bounds right on the inside, but still is not out of that pack.
Momentary offense by Sassy Longlegs there helped to free Pink Freud on a 4 point scoring pass.
And Jessica Boom just getting recycled back. Oh, big hit there at the front of the pack as Pink Freud trying to make it out.
Jessica Boom just took a hard shot in the back of the pack there. She went down right in front of the penalty box and
medics are coming out to check her out.
That jam was called because she went down and she is still down there on the track.
Luckily, the medics are right on top of it and are out there and checking her out, making sure that she will be okay. So 8 minutes, 11 seconds left in this game.
Sacred City ahead by a score of 200 to 133.
And we want to remind everyone to stick around for the upcoming game. Again, that is going to be Angel City Derby Girls versus the Rat City Roller Girls. And after that, it's going to be Bay Area versus Denver. So all of the games today are going to be all kinds of awesome.
When we take a look into the Kansas City bench there as they are watching the medics tend to their teammate.
Oh, she's sitting up.
Stands up with the help of the medical staff, and she does skate back to the bench on her own power. Now, because the jam was stopped because of the injury, we will not see Jessica Boom skating for the next three jams.
And frankly, that is probably the best thing for her, because between that call-off and just the frustration she was experiencing going up against those Sacred blockers, this might actually be a good thing for her.
That well could be. She absorbed a ton of hits in the last two jams that she skated.
The penalty count overall, Kansas City with 31 penalties to Sacred's 51. Back on the Fast Girl start line, we have number three for Kansas City, Case Close, up against number 44, the Forecloser.
4-3 pack advantage in favor of Sacred City to start this jam. We see the braced two-wall defense by Kansas City to start. Tough Noogie's trying to guard the line. Forecloser rolls a little back to the inside, and she clears lead jammer Sacred City as Case Closed gets recycled back behind the pivot line.
Case Closed coming in, breaking through that Sacred ball.
Forecloser Bulldozer jumps the corner of the apex and shrugs off a hit from Enigma. While doing so, sticks the jump. 5-point scoring pass for Closer.
Case Close still trying to get out on her initial pass, finding no luck whatsoever. She's stuck behind Sassy Longlegs.
Finally going through the center of the defense there. She is able to clear for Kansas City. That is her initial pass. For Closer, working on a second scoring pass for Sacred City.
She decides to call it off as she didn't want to risk trying to break through that Kansas wall and incurring any jammer penalties.
So. Well, really, and at an 8-0 point differential, no need for her to push it as we are nearing the 7-minute mark in the second half. And there we see Forecloser with that tiny jump, shrugging off the hit from Enigma, and notice how she stuck her right leg down first. You would think the left leg would be the one to come down first, but she nails the right one and hits the jump.
And definitely, and she had room to spare there,
right,
as she made that landing. That was insane. Accelerator jamming for Kansas City up against Ariella Twister for Sacred City.
Well, and again, as talked about during the pregame, Kansas City deep on the skaters that they are willing to jam. An accelerator through lead jammer Kansas City right behind her, though. Ariella Twister giving up less than a quarter of the track.
Sacred City comes to a screeching halt to build that back wall, knocking Accelerator to the infield as she calls it off.
Now, Accelerator did not get any points on that. I thought that she'd done a really nice job swinging her hips to the inside, maybe picking off something, but no, shut out there.
She didn't stay in bounds, I think.
Okay, was that
so
what it was?
I think because she ended up in the infield, it's like, well, you don't get the points if you end up in the infield.
That's true. I thought maybe she'd swung her hips through on the inside just in time. Apparently not.
So the score is 133 for Kansas City, 210 for Sacred City. Pink Freud versus Mary Lou Wretched on the fast girl start line.
Pink Freud starts in the center, rolls to the outside. She clears with lead jammer for Sacred City. Meanwhile, Mary Lou Wretched being contained in the pack, still with the star on her helmet. Moved to the outside now, and she's going to be recycled by Sacred City. Pink Freud back into the pack and trying to push through the Kansas City defense at the front. Draws, gets a multiplayer block drawn on Enigma, and that's a 5-point scoring pass for Pink Freud.
That is Enigma's sixth penalty in this game with just over 5 minutes left.
Pink Freud bump and run there in the pack. Legal hit, 5-point scoring pass as Mary Lou Wretched also clear now on her initial pass.
There are only two Sacred blockers on the track, but they are trying to set the pace of the pack as Pink Freud comes through, just threads the needle, picks up her points, and calls it off.
Nice little slalom work there. Goes from the outside to the friendly side. Picked up a little bit of offense on the inside. Nicely done by Sacred City.
I want to say thanks to Derby Supply for sponsoring the penalty box all season long. All your Derby needs, derbysupply.net. Just hit it.
It looks like we have an official timeout down on the track. Being called by head ref Cirrhosis as he checks in with some of the non-skating officials at the center of the track. We now see Cirrhosis over at the penalty box talking to one of the skaters. That is number 94.
Talls.
And Talls returning to the bench area, so she may have been, she may have thought that a penalty had been whistled against her and decided voluntarily to take a 30-second seat in the penalty box. She was informed, though, that no, you don't have to sit there, actually.
Which is good, because she is sitting on 5 penalties. She doesn't want to get more.
No, does not need to volunteer herself a sixth. Jammers of record for this jam, number 44, the Forecloser for Sacred City, opposite Lady Killshot for Kansas City. Forecloser starting on the out, moves back to the end, and now in the center of the track, as is Lady Killshot. Lady Killshot trying to work against her defenders, and number 3 in the front of the pack, Sassy Longlegs. Lady Killshot able to clear. Lead jammer goes to Kansas City.
Look at her. She's adjusting her shoelace as she, or her skate lace as she is doing her lap. And really good work from her using that shoulder to break through that Sacred wall. And now she comes through picking up 4 points for Kansas City.
So Lady Killshot in control of the jam. Forecloser closing in on the back of the pack. Skates by Annie Mall, then accelerates into turn 1.
That forces the call off from Lady Killshot. She has helped up Kansas City's points to 137 to Sacred's 226. And speaking of timeouts, there is one being called right now. So thank you, Spank Alley, for sponsoring the team timeouts. Wonderful armbands that are fully adjustable and fully customizable. Say no to Texta, spankalley.com.au.
I'm going to go over some points real quick. Track Rat for Kansas City, 39 points over 8 jams. Jessica Boom, 38 points in 11. And Case Closed, 35 in 10 for Sacred City. Ariella Twister leading all jammers with 99 points in 13 jams. 69 points for the forecloser in 12.
So, little clarification on Cirrhosis is going over to the penalty box and telling Talls that she can leave. Two skaters were called for destroying the pack, but only one should have served, and that one was not Talls, and that is why she was told, no, you don't have to go anywhere. And we have another foul out on the Sacred side. That is Annie Ankelbiter earning her 7th penalty. We just saw her smiling as she skated off the track. She's like, yeah, I know I did bad, but my team's in the lead, so meh.
So that is 3 skaters now unavailable for Sacred City, though they have less than 4 minutes left in this bout. Case Closed through the pack first lead. Jammer going to Kansas City. Ariella Twister also out of the pack, giving up a little less than half the track to Case Closed. Case Closed tries to duck to the outside. Gets moved to the outside after picking up 3 points and calls off the jam.
That's right. She got that little bump from Talls and decided that she doesn't need to fight this stuff. She could just call it off after scoring some points.
And Kansas City going to take another team timeout, it appears.
Wow, Spank Alley, you are getting your money's worth. Say no to Texta. Get Spank Alley armbands fresh from Australia. They are fully adjustable and customizable. SpankAlley.com.au. And also want to give another thanks to Derby Supply for all of your derby needs. DerbySupply.net. Just hit it.
So, Tara, real quick, your thoughts on why Kansas City's taking another timeout? Sacred City is down 3 skaters. They have only 11 left. They're in control of this bout, really. Why would Kansas City want to give Sacred a little more breathing room?
I don't know if they're trying to give Sacred more breathing room. I think they're trying to give themselves more breathing room and kind of say, all right, remember that time when we were having those scoring runs? That was because we were doing X, Y, and Z. And I think they're reiterating what worked for them because we can see them right now lined up on the pivot line.
Kansas City down 1 blocker.
Sacred City building a back wall there behind Kansas City. Kansas City has the tripod going on at the front right on the pivot line. Pink Freud going down. She got a little bit of an assist from Sassy Longlegs.
And Sassy Longlegs started out the jam trying to play a little bit of offense for Pink Freud. She's dropped back and joined the defense now as both teams going all defense.
That's right, Track Rat trying to just force her way through. She can't even find any space to get a shoulder in there to try and pry open that wall. That gives Pink Freud the chance to get out and get lead for Sacred City.
Laura Stabs to the penalty box for Sacred City. Track Rat clear on her initial pass for Kansas City as Pink Freud now working on a scoring pass.
Nice recycling by Foxy Brown trying to stop Pink Freud there at the end. And
it was nice that people knew that they had their skates tangled up with one another and everybody's like, all right, don't move. Let's figure this out first.
And I was like, okay. It's okay.
Safety first, ask questions later. Yeah,
definitely. 2:12 left in this game. 140 points for Kansas City, 228 for Sacred City. And on the Fast Girl start line, we have number 3, Case Closed, going up against number 44, the Forecloser.
Case Closed goes to the outside to start. Forecloser starts on the inside. She moves to the out as Case Closed goes to the end and gets around Blushy Lushy lead jammer going to Kansas City. And Forecloser thought she had daylight in front of her. Wall slammed in her face. She gets recycled. Again goes to the outside trying to clear on her initial, and it's Annie Mall moving her to the outside and directing her blockers to recycle her.
And she does get recycled back as Case Closed comes through. That is 5 points for Kansas City.
Forecloser crashing into the pack on the outside of turn four, clears the pack coming out of turn four on her initial. Case closed back, looking for more points for Kansas City, going to the inside, trying to stay in bounds, watching for Forecloser, and then calls off the jam after having picked up two more points.
That puts Kansas City 147 points to Sacred's 228 with just over a minute left in this game. So that means, at the rate things are going, I'm just going to say that on Sunday morning, we are going to probably see a rematch of the finals from
the D2 tournament.
From Detroit, Nashville versus Sacred City.
Ariella Twister.
Nice, just bouncing off at Kansas defense, not letting that slow her down. She gets out and gets lead.
Well, the next point that Ariella Twister picks up will be her 100th, and she hits the back of the pack and has already gotten credit for that. Mary Lou Wretched threw the pack on her initial. Ariella Twister clears. That's a four-point scoring pass. Checks in with her bench and calls off the jam.
17 seconds left on the clock. Is anyone going to call a timeout?
Looks like we've got an official review, and that official review being used most likely as a team timeout.
Smart move. Get one more jam in. Why not? It's
well,
fun.
You know, even when you're behind.
Their official review as a timeout. Play will resume in 1 minute.
In that case, we're going to go ahead and keep it right here. Well, Tara, just because you're losing in a game doesn't mean that all of your points aren't important. As we've seen throughout the tournament season, heck, as we saw through the regular season, you try and put as many points on the board as possible. You try and get as high as a percentage of the total points as possible to help increase your rankings, if humanly possible, or slighten the detriment, you know. So Kansas City going to give it one more roll. Hopefully for them, after taking the timeout, they can close that point differential a little more. But as you alluded to earlier, Sacred City's got this one in hand.
Yes, that means the Sunday 2 p.m. game, Sacred City will be facing Nashville.
There's Ariella Twister and Lady Killshot. Lady Killshot just missed that last second hit, and then Enigma unable to stop her as well. Ariella Twister, 103 points and 15 jams.
Starting this last jam with the pack on the pivot line, and we have Case Close versus Pink Floyd on the Fast Girl start line.
Case closed 45 points to her credit so far. Going to try and add to that total and shorten the difference between these two teams.
Pink Floyd, she's pushing on the Kansas City walls, but not pushing too hard. She doesn't want to get another penalty. That gives Case Close the chance to pick up lead.
On Case Close with a body whip off of Foxy Brown there, and then Foxy Brown turns around and starts playing defense immediately against Pink Floyd. Good containment by Kansas City. They're going to get what they wanted out of this, a few more points.
Case Close getting caught up in the back of the pack by Blushy Lushy.
Forecloser out there as a blocker. She is the pivot.
And she's on her way to the Derby Supply penalty box. But better as a blocker than a jammer.
Pink Floyd skated through a four-point scoring pass for her. Case Close picked up another four, though, so that is a plus four-point differential for Kansas City right now. But Pink Floyd working over the pack first. Case Close goes outside, finds room to work, darts back to the inside, and she clears 5 points on that scoring pass.
And she's in control. She can call off the jam at any time. The period clock has run out, but again, she wants to get all of the points as much as possible, so she comes in for another scoring pass.
Raina Payne trying to play some offense on the inside. Gets knocked down by Pink Floyd.
Pink Floyd getting knocked to the infield as well, so she recycles behind.
Case Close looked like she's sucking a little bit of wind right there. It has been a long bout, and finally she calls off the jam. Did pick up four more points in that final pass. Our score may be unofficial, but this bout is certainly final. Sacred City victorious against Kansas City. We will make sure that all the points have been tallied. Right now we're showing a score of 242 to 160.
And final penalties, blocker penalties, Kansas City picking up 26 to Sacred's 43. And again, par for the course for Sacred. That's just what they do. Jammer penalties, Kansas City had 9 to Sacred's 14. So the total, 35 penalties on the Kansas City side to 57 from Sacred City. Wow.
The score now is officially final. Sacred 242, Kansas 1, City and Terra on that point that you made. Sacred was just fairly dominant this bout. To have that many more penalties than your opposition and still have that large a point differential at the end. Sacred City lost three skaters to were expelled, essentially.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly. So
they did bad things, but in one form or another, and they had to pay.
That's right. You're absolutely right.
And to be honest, Kansas City, I expected a little more consistency from them. They had their moments of brilliance. They had these runs where they were getting points. They just weren't able to maintain that momentum.
No, and it seemed like when Sacred would counter, the point differentials in those jams would be greater than Kansas City could muster when they were going on those runs. It was a good bout by Sacred City and a good bout by Kansas City. Good to see both teams come out here and fight it out.
And again, we're going to be able to see each of these teams one more time this weekend.
That's right. Sunday.
Sacred City versus Nashville, as I've said several times, and Kansas City will be facing Demolition City for the third place game.
Well, fans, we are going to thank some sponsors real quick, and then we will be back with Derby Nerd's interview after the break.
Welcome back, Trackside Post Game, the victors, Sacred City, heading to the Division II championships. This must be a huge experience for you guys, especially after a year off last year. You had four straight years in the playoffs, including the Division I's in 2013. How did that time off from the playoffs last year help to re-energize this squad going into 2015?
Well, we definitely missed the experience at the end of the season, completing the season with playing in a playoffs.
Yeah.
But last year, because of hosting a division playoffs and then raising money to travel, it just was not possible for our team. But we took that and we bottled up all that energy that we reserved by not going, and we pushed through this season. And we actually started our season fairly early this year because of having that downtime in October, November, and December. So we've been going since January.
Oh, that's interesting. So you did build that in to get prepared for the playoffs.
Right.
Now, D2s in Detroit were phenomenal. Your championship game with Nashville has already gone down as one of the great tournament finals in WFTDA history. Mm-hmm. We get to see a rematch of that this weekend. You guys were so close in that game. It was anyone's game, really. Do you guys think you've made the adjustments to be able to take down Nashville now?
We have made the adjustments to successfully master the errors that we feel we made. However those cards fall on Sunday, that's what it'll be, win or lose. But our focus this game and Sunday is purely performance. We're not focusing on winning. So it's a little different, you know, to take that out of the equation. But we know that we're penalty heavy. We know that there's distractions that happen in a game and mentally fatigue happens. So we're trying to hone that area in. And we believe if we can succeed there, we will win.
Right. So. Well, you saw that this game, too. Things got really messy in the second half. There were a lot of penalties being called, jammer penalties, blocker penalties on both sides. And you guys had a certain calmness on the bench. I liked how your bench is set up where the next line is in the circle.
There's something to be said for, like, always getting penalties. You just get used to it. Just go to the box, serve your time.
Is it your bench staff? Is it the team's personality?
Yes.
What is it that keeps the calmness there?
So what we have decided is that if our blocker jammers go to the box, it is the track pack. It's their responsibility to hold it down while our players are in the box. So it's nobody's fault. There's no pointed fingers. Oh, you messed up. You know, you caused the team to lose, or, you know, the other team earned points because you were in the box. It's actually almost like a push to the track pack to hone in on what they're going to do to hold it down while the blocker or the jammer's in the box. So I don't know if you noticed, when our jammers did go to the box, our blockers held it down.
Oh,
if you look at, I'm sure those scoring passes were very few when our jammers were, when we were jammer down. And we have worked on that mental attitude. Not so much what are we going to do, it's that's your responsibility.
Right at the end of the first half, might have even been the last jam, they had a power jam. Things were still pretty close at that point in the game, and your line did come through and lock it down.
Right.
Didn't give up a scoring pass, I don't believe.
And the reality of it is, you can only control what you can control. So we can't make the jammer perform. I don't know what the other pack is going to do. to, the defending team that we're playing against. But what I do know is how I can play with my teammates when my jammer's in the box. So.
Well, and what you can control is your position in the Division II championship game.
We are very excited.
It's all set now. Sacred City versus Nashville coming up on Sunday. We've got a full day of derby left here, though, at the Roy Wilkins Auditorium. So thank you, and stay tuned at WFTDA.tv.